Hi guys, welcome to day 9 of the daily vlog. I'll be honest with you, the daily vlog is amazing and awful. It's amazing because I'm learning so much and I'm enjoying doing this. I'm enjoying the lessons that I learn so quickly in each day. So the cycle, the quick cycle, it works. It teaches me a lot about filmmaking and videos that I did not learn in years because the turnaround time is so fast. But it's also awful because of the same turnaround time, because it's very demanding. Right now, I'm just barely keeping afloat, posting every day. But other than that, I'm not getting time for anything else like any other project. I have a lot of other projects. Some of them are already shot and in the can, and I need to just post-process and post them. But they need time, which I'm putting into the daily vlog every day. And this is when I'm in between contracts. I work as a contractor. So right now I'm in between contracts and I have the whole day. Other than trying to find the next contract and doing daily vlog, I'm not doing a lot of other things. So once I get the job, it might even become more difficult. So the target is to have the vlog quality come up a little bit more, have better production quality, better production values, more good stories, and lots of good effects and everything, while taking lesser time in the post-processing. That's the target. It won't happen overnight, so I have to work towards that. And today's day is like a cheat day towards that end, as in reduce the post-processing time. So for that reason, I'm going to keep today's episode very, very simple so I can do it in one sitting and then edit it very quickly and just post it without having to spend hours. Usually it takes me at least 4 or 5 hours to do everything, even for these simple projects. So as I said, my filmmaking has to get better, more effective and more efficient. But the message from today is not going to be any least important. It's going to be an important message that I want to share with you. So let's get into it. There is this author, E.S. Gardner, Earl Stanley Gardner, and he has written a series of novels, I think more than one series actually, but this his most popular series is, oh God, this light is killing me. No, that's not the popular series. The popular series is Perry Mason. And Perry Mason is a lawyer. So not only is he a lawyer, but he's also a good guy. Sorry, that came out wrong. What I mean is that he's not just a good lawyer, but he's like a role model. So Gardner has put all the good traits in him. He fights for the underdog. He's very smart. He's adventurous and he goes out and does things himself. All kinds of good things that you could think of in a man. Perry Mason has those. And this will be illustrated by the one small part of a scene that I'm going to illustrate to you. I'm going to narrate to you. And this is, so Perry Mason has a sidekick, a private detective named Paul Drake. And while Perry Mason is like a proper role model kind of person, Paul Drake is good, efficient, rough and tough guy, but not as sophisticated, not as overall perfectly pure white good person as Perry Mason is. And then, of course, there's Jella Street, who is Perry Mason's private secretary. Oh, she's a character in herself and worth reading the books just for her. Wonderful character. So this is a scene from one of those lunches when Perry Mason is, he has a case in the court. Then he has lunch in a restaurant which is near the court, and he takes Paul Drake and Della Street with him. And after they finish the lunch, then he pays the bill, Mason pays the bill, and he adds a generous tip. And then he says to the maitre d'hotel, "Oh, that was wonderful meal. Please give our compliments to the chef and thank you very much for taking care of us," as he passes the money. And when they are leaving the restaurant, obviously the maitre d'hotel replies back and all is done. And then as they finish the transaction, they're getting out of the restaurant. Paul Drake says, Perry, why do you bother? Just the money would be enough. It was a generous tip. And Mason says these legendary words, legendary for me. He says, Paul, it takes both money and words. Money without words is vulgar, and words without money are cheap. I'll let that sink in. So, not that I used to treat people badly before that, or I didn't used to tip or anything, but that kind of added a dimension into my own personality. It taught me how to handle these situations and why to do this. So now it's changed my behavior a little bit, that now if I'm eating, if I have something that I ordered after a lot of discussion and then I didn't finish it, so I make sure to tell the waiter that, please tell the chef that it was really nice, I was just too full, or it was too much for me. Sorry. It might not be important, or it might be. Because somebody who takes pride in their work, somebody who takes pride in their cooking, and sees people returning half-eaten plates of food, then they might feel bad, they might feel depressed. That reminds me of another thing that I learned from Facebook, that some places, some restaurants, they do not share the tip amount with their waiting staff. In some companies, it goes to the company, it goes to the owners and not to the waiting staff. So they all have different policies. So after I read that, now I make a point to ask when I'm paying the bill, I ask if I pay by card, especially if you pay by card. So if I'm paying by card, would you get this? So then I find out the policy. It is shared with everybody, it is shared with the waiting staff and kitchen staff, or if you pay by card, it goes to the company. If you pay by cash, then it goes to the waiting staff. So in that case, I take out the cash for that, pay the bill by the card, and then take out cash for the tip. So I'm sharing this so that you can also be mindful of that, whether you use this practice or not, that's up to you. And that reminds me of this incident in South Africa. Okay, that's going to remind me of another incident in Germany as well. This is going to get out of hand if I start talking and then just keep talking. So I'm going to finish this episode here, and then I'll see you tomorrow, and hopefully I'll keep at it and try to reduce the post-processing time so that I can give you better content in the same amount of effort, and the vlog can continue longer. Thank you very much for watching, and thank you for the support, all the views and the subscribers who are coming. Thank you. I do really appreciate you. See you tomorrow. Bye.